our trailer video tutorial series here, and what I want you to kind of recognize is a few new things that we haven't gone over yet, and that is when you click in your timeline, you will see a line that goes on your audio file. In order to see this line, sometimes what you have to do is increase the size by going right to this line here in between each of the layers of audio, and you can click and drag on it to make it larger so it would look like this. And then that white line comes up. That line is the volume of the track. The same thing exists on these audio files. All you have to do here is just increase that one, same sort of thing. And then you see that white line as well. You can control the volume of any clip. And so to do that, what you do is you take the pen tool on your toolbar here, and on that white line, you can create anchor points or dots, let's say. Okay. And what you want to do with those is, so for imagine here in the beginning, the sound is loud if I play it. Now, right about here, I want it to start dimming down because I want this audio clip to play and have this one fade. So I'm going to click on the line to create a dot, and you see a blue dot is created there. I can create as many of these dots as I would like along this path, and I'll give you an example here where I'm going to create a dip by going about here, and then I'm going to click another two. And in order to move the dots now around or pull them down or up, all I need is my arrow key, the selection tool at the top of the toolbar. And then I can go on these and I can simply move them. So now as this plays back, at that point, you're going to hear it dip. Now I dipped it all the way down so you can't hear it at all. If you want to hear it a little bit, don't bring it quite so low. And then the same goes for this one. So if I, in this particular video, I could take the pen tool, go to this one, click on that line, and again, I'm just going to zoom in a little bit so you could see better. And I can go on this one now, and I can just click, and I can up this. So where he's actually talking now, that's going to get louder. Like that. So you can control the audio of any clip, which I think is important. I'm going to undo all those steps for a moment. All right, so I went in here. I'm going to zoom out just a little bit more. And I started kind of editing some of these pieces. Here, if you take the selection tool, like I had mentioned last time, if you click and you make sure that this is unchecked, you can get rid of the audio of certain clips. So you can click on the video by itself or the audio and get rid of either one. So on these two first clips, I got rid of the audio. I like what the coach here is saying in this little clip here. I got rid of these two. Now I can extend this one where he's talking. So I'm gonna on this clip here, the sound underneath, the music underneath, I'm gonna mute that. And so on this one now, I can hear what's going on here. So right about there, he says, you know, this kid with this kind of talent. I like everything he said. I'm going to pick up now with that selection tool. I can pick up the entire volume without using any of those, pen tool little dots. I can just lift the whole thing up so it becomes much louder across the board.
To go into the NBA, because so many kids are doing it, and you see a kid with this kind of talent, it's almost normal for him to take that into consideration with the kind of money they're getting now. But I would tell him.
Now I'm going to extend it past here.
That he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he had.
My mother, she...
Okay, and I'm going to stop it right there when his little conversation is done.
Save the money that he had.
So right about there. I'm going to pull it right to here. And so if you look at what actually is happening in the program window here, as I play this back...
To go into the NBA, because so many kids are doing it, and you see a kid with this kind of talent... It's almost normal for him to take that into consideration with the kind of money they're getting now. But I would tell him that he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has.
Okay, so the audio goes past where the video actually is. I can begin to bring these clips back over. So I can drag these over to here, Same thing with this one. Now, remember, right now I have that little length selection thing unchecked. I'm going to undo. I can turn it back on so that when I click on a clip, it moves both of them at the same time. So what's an interesting thing to do sometimes is to eliminate some of the audio by unchecking the link, right? So I can grab this audio, hit delete, this audio, hit delete, but then actually use this clip as part of something else. You can also take clips, move them out of the way, and slide other ones over. So like I could take this clip now and this and bring it over. If they're together, they move like this. But if you uncheck them, I can just move just one, even though the audio of this one is over here, right? You can move them. So what I'd like to do here is I'm going to take the audio away from this really long clip, but I'm going to slide it on top of this one. So now as you watch it.
But I would tell him that he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has.
Right. Now, if I turn on the bottom one and unmute that as well, now you get this.
Consideration is the kind of money that you get now, but I would tell him that he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has.
Okay, the only problem is obviously for that little part you can't really hear. So we got to take that little pen tool, like I said. We're going to click on this line. During that time that he's speaking, I'm going to bring these down a little bit. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing there. And we can increase this a little bit just by bringing those dots up. Now let's hear what this sounds like.
Going into the NBA, because so many kids are doing it. When you see a kid with this kind of talent, it's almost normal for him to take that into consideration with the kind of money they're getting now. But I would tell him that he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has.
Okay, so your cuts here with these little dips in the audio can be really anywhere you want. You can move them and get them as accurate as you want them to be. Also, when you're playing these things back, one thing to notice is as I raise the volume of his voice and you play it, on the right-hand side here, you're going to see the audio levels booming up real high.
This kind of talent, it's almost.
If you notice, they're getting into the orange and red area at the top. If you see a lot of that, you're going to want to bring down the volume there so it's not quite so high.
With this kind of talent, it's almost normal for him to take that into consideration with the kind of money that they're getting now, but I would tell him that he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has.
So, I'm going to mute this again. I'm going to continue to watch this clip. I'm going to see if I can cut this up a little bit. These two clips on the top, I can always move them over and maybe use them later or possibly not at all. I'm going to play the clip, and see. I want to show a little bit of the surrounding area. That's why I think this beginning clip is important here. But you can move any of these clips around. Take the little razor blade tool here on the toolbar. I like kind of this to here, to the court. Right about there. I'm going to cut that. I could then take the selection tool. I could move this one over here and move these, and even this if I wanted to, sort of like back over to here. Drop this one under. If you want to click on a dot, you can hit delete on a dot and get rid of any of the dots if you had changed the volume at all, and that will delete anything you did. So now it looks like this. So I'm going to just add those little dots and rework the volume like we discussed.
But I would tell him that he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has.
Okay, so we're going to continue just to break this up, cut it up, adjust the volume, and make things, you know, sort of, or try our best, and this is the hardest part, to make sense out of what we're seeing in that minute, minute and a half. Only other tool that we should be using for this, so we just discussed that you can use the razor blade to cut, which you guys know already. Then we talked about the pen tool, which you could use for your volume. And then the rate stretch tool, which should be here, where you can hit R on your keyboard to get to it. So it's the third tool down, and then you just click and hold, and you get this one. Rate stretch, what that will help you do is you can literally change the pace of what's happening, but keep it within the same time frame. So it kind of looks like this. So right now, if we were to watch this little clip, like right here. So I'm going to cut this clip first. Let's take the selection tool. Let's go to this clip. I'm just going to get the part that I want from it. Okay, I'm going to move these two clips because they're kind of annoying me. I'm going to get them out of the way so they don't interfere. Then on this clip, right before it shows the prison, I'm going to stop the clip right there. I'm going to use my knife. I'm going to cut that clip. I'm going to move this one over. So now I have just this piece here. Now, just this piece, if you zoom into it, you see how long this piece is. I mean, literally right now, it lasts for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you know, lasts for about 8 seconds or so. But if you go back to that rate stretch tool, what you can do is you can click on the edge of the clip and pull it so it matches where you want it to go, right by the end of where he's saying. What that does, by pulling it to the left, you're shrinking it. You're lessening the amount of time that it shows up on the screen. So you're quickening the pace, right, of what's there. If I brought it to the right, it would be elongating it. It would be stretching it out, and the time would last longer. So it would have to slow the clip down in order for it to play for a longer bit of time. So let's just see what it looks like.
That he needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has.
Now, I think that happens to look ridiculous because it looks like he's in fast motion, right? So let's undo that. If I stretch it out, just want you to see, the same exact clip now.
He needs to go to college and get an education so he'll be able to save the money that he has. Year by year, all the sense disappears. Nonsense perseveres, prayers lives with fear.
Beware, two triple M. It might feel good, it might sound a little something. Right? So you can use that rate stretch tool to help you out, to kind of fill in the gaps by stretching something to make it last longer, or bringing it, you know, shrinking it in order for it to last for less amount of time. So we're going to go in now, and we're going to continue with those tools, cutting, using the pen tool and the rate stretch tool to help us. If you find you have any gaps in between your clips and you want to quickly bring them together, you can right click and do ripple delete, and it will pull the clips and smack them kind of back to each other. The only other thing we're going to add in the last trailer here, and it should look a little bit like this. We have already organized our things. We're going to cut them up. We showed some unforgettable scenes, which will be coming up at the end. Use a voiceover or text to help tell the story. So that's the last video that I'm going to make about how you can create a voiceover or how you can add text. The music we already put in to help set the tone. The editing techniques to control the pace, that was the rate stretch tool that I just told you about. And then highlight the film's talent. We already kind of did number 6 inside of 1 and 2 by throwing in, you know, a lot of the characters or potentially listing them at the end. So this says, you know, the cast run list of actors who appear on the film, big name actors, producers, writers, blah, 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 blah. Right? So we can grab that from the end of the movie or the beginning of the movie and put that in as well. And I'll show you that in the final